mailbag.
Mailbag!
All right, if you have a question, you can head to the website, thefantasyfootballers.com. Click the Submit a Question button. You can also dial our voicemail hotline. That's 302-464-TFFB. Let's kick this thing off with a couple of very open-ended, what do I do questions. What do I do with David Johnson?
Wait, is this... Did this come in from Cliff Kingsbury?
Oh, my goodness.
Multiple people asking this question, I believe.
Steve Keim.
S. Keim, yeah, is one of those people.
Michael Bidwell.
Mm-hmm.
Kenyon Drake.
It looks like one of these questions came in from David Johnson.
Oh, no. Listen, if you've been on, I think, Jason or my Twitter over the last day, you've seen a few tweets that include a video.
Oh,
and it shows,
goodness.
It shows somebody named David Johnson running laterally. Running is way too kind of a word. Meandering laterally and then deciding where to fall.
How to get pancaked.
Yes. And this, you know, we're from, this has multiple layers of sadness for us because we're from Arizona, mm-hmm. Cardinal fans. We know David Johnson.
Love David Johnson.
Spent time with him.
Great guy.
And I choose to believe this is related to what Cliff Kingsbury has said this week. Multiple injuries. Ankle, back, problems. Because if it's not, David Johnson's time as a professional, not just a fantasy option, but as like a mainstay in the backfield, is going to be over. That being said, what do you do with him now as a fantasy owner? What are you thinking about?
The only thing you can do is the same thing that Cliff Kingsbury did, and that's bench him. You obviously can't move on from him. You can't drop him. You're not going to be able to trade him for the name value after the run of disappointing games. That window is closed. So it's actually a really, really easy decision. You have to bench him. And it's brutal, but it's easy. He belongs on your bench. You cannot start him until he looks healthy on the field.
Yeah.
And you're gonna take a loss, hopefully. Hopefully, you're going to take a loss one of these weeks on having a good game on your bench. But you're going to prepare yourself by getting all the bad ones out of the way first. And if you – I went back and watched Cliff Kingsbury's press conference yesterday because I wanted to specifically see what he was saying about David Johnson. And he got benched because he wants to put the best players on the field. And when he was asked, is this going to go forward? Is this going to impact his playing time? Cliff Kingsbury said, you know, I'm going to – just put the best player on the field that gives us the best chance to win. And David Johnson's great. And when he's ready, you know, then he'll be out there. But, I mean, essentially, he's not ready. He's not going to be the lead dog. I think Kenyon Drake could very well be the leader this coming week.
Yeah, he could be. And then the matchup is against San Francisco. And lucky for DJ, they have the bye week coming up still. So he could be ready to go for the end of the year. But
well, Chase,
until then,
Chase Edmonds is going to come back after the bye week as well.
True.
And so you'll have three situations. And you wonder why you brought Kenyon Drake in, right? If they thought David Johnson was a guarantee to come back to form, you don't necessarily make that trade in the middle of the season. So it makes you question things. You're 100% right. You cannot rest on the laurels of the past. You will lose with your fantasy team.
Thank you so much for watching that video. It would make me so happy if you watched more of those videos. So click subscribe, ring that bell, and make your life a little better today.